Charlotte Saul, and I'm IRAP Student Coordinator. This year, the remote environment has allowed chapter leaders to connect and innovate more than ever before. And in that vein, we're thrilled to acknowledge two excellent cross-chapter initiatives this year. The first is a climate displacement conference that was co-organized by the IRAP chapters at the University of Alabama School of Law, the George Washington University Law School, and American University Washington College of Law. We especially want to congratulate Haley Zarnick, the chapter director for IRAP Alabama's chapter, for all of her efforts making this event happen. This March, Haley and the team put together a day-long conference on climate displacement in the Americas, bringing together multiple panels of lawyers and practitioners who are all invested in the intersection between climate and migration. We're excited to acknowledge this initiative, and we really hope it paves the way for future cross-chapter collaborations in other years.
Hi, my name is Haley Zarnick. I am a 2L at the University of Alabama, where I'm currently our chapter director for IRAP. At this year's virtual summit, I was able to pitch an idea that I was very excited about for a student-run virtual conference on the topic of climate displacement. And from that pitch, I was able to get together a couple of folks from other chapters and also a number of people from our Alabama chapter. And we've been working very hard since October to put that conference on. I'm very excited to say that it went wonderfully. We had three panels followed by a discussion. I know that folks had a lot to say about their takeaways from the day. We started with Californians who've been working to respond to wildfires, and then we heard from folks around the country about how we can be an advocate outside of the realm of litigation, and also about what the international legal landscape looks like for those who are displaced by climate. I am really grateful to IRAP to have had such a supportive national team as we were working on this project, because I think we were able to have discussions that oftentimes are overlooked when it comes to refugee rights.
Our second set of honorees is Ryan Durazzo and Tina Al-Kirsan, the co-leaders of IRAPSA, the IRAP Student Assembly. Since its inception last fall, IRAPSA has become a key way to build connections and share best practices across IRAP's student network. This year, Ryan and Tina led a team of 9 students from across the network, hosting events, forging connections, and building an infrastructure for cross-chapter engagement that will last long beyond their tenure. We look forward to seeing how IRAPSA grows and evolves, and we are so grateful to Ryan and to Tina for their vision and leadership this year.
Hi, my name is Ryan Durazzo, and I am the facilitator and co-founder of the International Refugee Assistance Project's Student Assembly. So the Student Assembly was a project my co-founder and I, Tina Al-Kirsan, and I started last summer. With the pandemic, we felt like students and advocates were feeling more isolated than ever. And the work, though, we had to accomplish was more urgent than ever. So we wanted to give a chance for students to bring their ideas together, to network, to share their wisdom, and make a bigger, more coordinated impact. And it's been really exciting seeing it grow over the course of this year. I'm a graduating 3L this spring, but I'm really looking forward to seeing what the next generation of IRAP students can accomplish by working together.